or AI tools that we use to create these gorgeous videos are not free. And one thing I've noticed, they do add up. But if you want something good, you need to pay for it. In this video, I want to show you the options that are available to you and how you can use your CapCut effectively for maximum benefit. But first, let me show you what CapCut can create for you with different videos and music and images that we've created using our CapCut tool. Let's enjoy.
Boys were playing and one of them lost his shoes. Now he's scared to go home because his mother is going to be so upset with him. I don't want to go home.
You've been slogging through business studies, but when exam time comes, it feels like a storm. What if I told you there are moves that separate the ones who pass with...
Hey everyone and welcome back to the channel. If you're part of the Matric class of 2025, this video is especially for you. I know the final exams can feel like a huge mountain to climb, but trust me, with the right strategy, you can absolutely conquer it. Today,
you are going to either select your AI video maker, or if you have images that you want to start with and change them to videos or create your new images, it depends on what is it that you would like to do. So I want to start showing you, if you have a project that you want to start with and you want to create media and videos and audio, then you just click to open a new project. This is where you're going to get AI media, AI avatars could also be selected on your left hand side. If we select AI media, we are then able to write a prompt so that we can create an image. And we can create a video from image to video. Text to video is also available. And then we can do the talk or sing, which is your lip sync. So now we can clearly see that CapCut is trying to really replace the other tools with a payment of $129. So this is a paid CapCut that I'm using. It is not a free one. If I want to start by creating an image, I can describe the image like I would do on Canva AI or Leonardo, and then if I have an image to be referenced, I can add my image and then ask the tool to create the image that's referenced in the one that I've attached. So if you've ever used your text to image, same principle, it doesn't change. What is exciting for me is if you were using Leonardo or the other apps, you can now really come in here and describe the image that you would like to use and go ahead and create it. And with the credits that they're going to take, they give you 1,200 credits for the basic pro plan. So let's get a nice prompt from ChatGPT and then we create the image together. So I'm gonna paste my prompt over here and I'm gonna add the Lenovo image of my avatar to have this tool reference it so that we can compare and see. I add my reference image and then so there are different models. There's a 4.0 and a 3.0. It's up to you whichever one you want to use, but you can also pick your aspect ratio. Are you creating for TikTok or YouTube or Facebook? It depends. You can then start generating the image and you wait for the tool to generate the image. And there you go. It has created a set of images that can be seen. And they really look really beautiful. So if you wanted to compare with one that was created by ChatGPT and CapCut created these for me. So if you hover, you can change the image to video, you can download the image. And every time you are on this project, you will be able to see your AI images that you've created before. But I love that immediately while you're here, that's the second option, the AI video. So we can use the image to video option, then it immediately adds it to the AI video, and then we can describe what we want the person to do, and then we can pick a model. You can choose any of these models. Just take note of the 4.0. When you're using this model, you are going to be using up 320 credits that you have that have been allocated to you. So just make sure you pick the right one for you, and then you generate the video that you would like to generate. So it does generate 10 seconds videos. If you scroll down, if you want a 5 seconds video of that aspect ratio, you get to use up 25 credits. If you want 10 seconds long videos, then you're going to use up 50 credits. So just make your choice and then choose your model, and then you can select generate, and then it starts generating the video for you. Then it shows me that clearly the 2.0 is not as cool as we want. If I were creating this video, I would zoom in to where she's talking to the camera and take out the legs, and then I would add a lip sync to her, like a dialogue, and then have that carry on. If you use the other models, you'll get a little bit more generation on your videos other than the 2.0, but you're gonna use up a little bit more credits when you are using the other video generation. So let's use this one, the 3.1, so that I can show you what I mean, that it starts generating. So your videos are gonna sit all here, all of them that you've created. Like I've said earlier on, you can download and keep them on your phone and go edit elsewhere if you don't want to use CapCut. And wow, I did say the avatar. Now it has changed the image to an avatar. So let's see how she looks like on the 3.0. That's supposedly better than the 2.0. And then she changes to an avatar. Okay, I did write avatar, literally changed my avatar to avatar from the movies. That's actually cool, but I just wanted you to see how you create these videos like you've seen at the introduction of this video. So with the AI dialogue scene, you can make characters on your photo talk, sing, or react with multiple characters. You pick who can talk. It's actually really quite cool as well. You are going to be using 6 credits in order for you to do that. You upload your photo and then you have people dialoguing. So we need another video that explains just that, and I will create that. Let's go to the AI video maker that is actually changing the way that I'm creating my videos for my YouTube channels. You open it up, and then you're going to get options for new project, AI instant video. You can brainstorm with CapCut's AI. You can create an avatar video, and you can match media to script, and then you upload a video and then it creates it for you. To start with, are these AI templates that you could use to create your TikToks or your YouTube shorts. You can scroll through all of these templates and pick any of these templates that you want to use, and then you create your video by writing a script, and that's pretty much it. It's simple and easy to be creating this short. So let's pick this one that is African, because I'm from Africa, and then you can write a little story of what you want the video to be about. A boy, an animal, gets along well. So click on create, and the AI starts generating a video for us for a YouTube short or a TikTok. And your video is created, so you can scroll through and listen to the voiceover that was created automatically, and you can change media as well. So if you want to watch the video, it's 49 seconds long, just click on play.
Ever wonder if animals have their own secret language? Out here, it feels like I'm starting to understand it.
So when you look at the video, you are able to delete voiceover and replace it with your own. And picking the voiceover and replacing, you are also able to replace images. So you can go ahead and click on images to replace, and then look for either AI or stock images or your own media images, and then you replace them and your video is done. So as quick and easy as that, that's how you would create your TikToks or your YouTube Reels. So if you wanted to create a new project, you're gonna click there and then it opens up a new project for you that you can enter your own script or you can create one with AI. So it needs a topic and key points for it to generate a script for you that could be 1 minute, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, or 10 minutes long. You do have the option of adjusting your scenes with your voiceovers, as well as generating your own media or matching your own media using stock media. So this is the scenes when we adjust things and we become video editors. And then there's elements. This is where the system adds music automatically for you, and it also adds captions and sounds and sticker effects. It's quite cool that it makes your video come really alive with the elements that are available. And the last option is music, where you can pick and add music to your video. So if you go back to generate with AI, you select create one with AI, then you're going to write your topic as well as your key points, and then you want to scroll down, pick the duration of your video, and then click on create. It then starts generating the script, and then you wait until it's done. And once it's created the script, you can cancel or ask it to create again, or you could just select use. Then we're gonna go to our scenes. It depends on how you would like to tell the story. You can use an avatar. You scroll down, you pick an avatar that you would like to use to tell your story. And at the same time, you can go to your scenes and select on media to have the story told via generated media, your own photos, or the stock photos that's available on CapCut. So it depends exactly how you want your story to be told. And our scenes are created depending on the type of video that you want to have created. If you want to move your avatar to the side or remove them completely, it's up to you. So the tool is versatile and it does so much that you can play around and have lots of beautiful creations using your CapCut. So when you hover on an image, you can select replace, you can cut and trim, or you could delete. So it's up to you when you're looking at all of the images. You're like, okay, I don't like this one, or I want to replace this one. You just click on replace, and then you then can choose your own media or stock media or AI media. So you can then write a little script of what the image should be, and then you generate, and then it gets replaced, as easy as that. Trick here is, if you want to edit some more, you click on edit more, and then it opens up the projects on CapCut, and then you can make changes. However, as you've seen earlier on, you can replace the images or the videos with stock photos or stock videos or your own photos that you've generated from somewhere else to create something that you really want. And there you go. It opens up your CapCut timeline, and then you can do editing manually the way that you want. If you want your zoom in and panning the way that you want to replace images, it's up to you. And then you have your video. When you export, that's it. It's done. You click on export and you pick your resolution and the format of how it should look like. And then you export. and your video is done and dusted.